Ah. Cantata, 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 cantata. Start at 11. Start at 11. Hop, hop. Huh? Yeah, skipping.
Good morning, class of 2023, family, friends, and staff. It has been a great honor to serve as secretary these past 4 years as I have watched my classmates thrive at BC. I cannot wait to celebrate you all with this beautiful ceremony today and watch as you chase your dreams in your next endeavors.
I pledge allegiance Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you.
Oh, Good afternoon. Superintendent Hansen, members of the Elmbrook School Board, esteemed faculty, staff, family, friends, and most importantly, the BC class of 2023. It is a special day as we come together to celebrate and say goodbye to a tremendous group of individuals. Many staff members helped organize today's event. Two people in particular, BC Office Manager Evelyn Martin and Student Services Administrative Assistant Natalie Ferschel, checked everything. Let's give them a great hand. Also, thank you to Ryan Fitzpatrick and Allie Hickman and the many talented BC musicians for today's music. Let's give them a hand. And throughout today's ceremony, we'll have graphics and video. And four people worked tirelessly to pull this off. Aviana Mater, Pudge Manahar, Alyssa Tang, and Andrea Della Penna. Let's give them a hand. Many BC staff members are in attendance today. Thank you for your great work this year and every year as you provide tremendous care for the students of BC. Please stand to be recognized for a round of applause. Thank you to the Brookfield East team for their hospitality and partnership in coordinating this event. And lastly, thank you to our almost 3,000 guests from coming from far and near to celebrate as we watch 303 amazing people walk across the stage. Enjoy the day. Thank you.
Henry, do you need a hug?
No, I need lunch money.
Lunch money? We put $100 in your account last week.
That was last week.
All right. Love ya.
Yep.
Love ya. Uh-huh. I'll take that as he loves me. Okay, go. All right, here we go.
Hey, good morning, BC class of 2023. Hope everyone's having a great weekend. One last preview in the week. Let's take a look. First, looking back, started the week with the first annual cap and gown walk. Great new tradition at BC. It was fantastic to see all the video and pictures from you guys back at your elementary schools. And then this was great. You know, a lot of schools have to deal with senioritis where seniors don't want to come to school anymore. I know it's crazy to think. But here you guys were 90 minutes before school, ready to go. I guess there's a reason why we have the highest ACT scores in the state. On a side note, Will Miller, your fire pit's still in the front of school. If you could pick that up as soon as possible, that'd be fantastic. And then we had senior sunset. Great to be together out on the turf. Beautiful night. And then one of my favorite traditions is BC biking to school. Appreciate the help of Brookfield PD in this endeavor. Just a beautiful morning. I think we had as many bikers as ever. So thank you to all that dusted off the old Huffy and got outside. And then this was great. I know a lot of you just wanted to leave to get going on for, you know, preparing for graduation, but you stuck around to say goodbye to the underclassmen. And I know they were absolutely touched that you thought of them. So thank you much for that. You know, just a few things that I'd like you to consider. And I'm going to start with what I think is maybe the most important thing. I know a lot of things are going to be said today. So I'm going to start with my most important thing. So, you know, you will come up against challenges. And that advice comes from my heart. And I hope that it resonates with you. It's guided me throughout my life. So some things to consider. Getting ahead of myself here. First senior send-off is tonight, 9 p.m. to 1 a.m., $35 cash at the door. So some things to consider as you venture out with your clean slate, because right now everyone has a clean slate. is first and foremost showing up and being present. Take a look at these graphics. Top one is for college. Bottom one is work. Yellow is the time you're in class at work. Blue is free time. So lots of free time. Now remember, you won't receive attendance emails or 10-day letters. And if you don't attend, remember, life doesn't wait for you to be at 100%. So you got to get up every morning, keep pushing through it, and remember to be the hammer, not the nail. You know, and our world is full of a lot of distractions. It's important to live in the moment.
As parents, we love to attend your events. And the first thing we do at an event is to find where you are in the crowd, or the stage, or on the court. Pretty likely that they found you as you walked in, and many are probably looking at you right now. As parents, our number one goal is to make sure that you are safe. And as you venture off to your next step in life, we know that you'll be in very new and unfamiliar environments. Be sure to always have friends with you that will watch out for you, and you will watch out for them. Just like driving, always leave yourself an out. And remember, if you ever get in a jam or unsure what to do, just call us, no matter what time it is. We will always be there to help you through it. Class of 2023, remember each day is a gift. Cherish your relationships. Be the same person online that you are in person. Don't spend too much time online. Don't quit a job before you have your next job, and choose your friends wisely. There's an old adage, you're the average of the five people you spend the most of the time with. It is more important than ever to surround yourself with good people, people who bring out the best in you, and you in return will help them be their best. People who care for you and that you in turn will care for. People who do the right thing and will help you do the right thing. And remember, nothing good happens after midnight. And use the words from my childhood minister to guide you as you start your next chapter in life. He ended each of his services with the following. Go forth in the world in peace. Be of good courage. Hold fast to which is good. Render unto no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted, support the weak, help the afflicted, honor everyone.
Here's a picture from the first time we met. That's freshman year orientation. And I think about what you did to get to this point. Very, very proud of you. And remember, for one last time, search the world for the positives and never, never miss a chance to say thank you. Be well, be kind, be safe. Take care of yourself, BC Class of 2023.
Thank you. GPS assistant at East doesn't go up to 11 like the one at Central.
No!
Yep.
So thank you for your patience, and glad that we're able to see that video because the four girls really worked very, very hard at that. It's my pleasure to introduce Senior Class Treasurer Arisha Sobhani for the presentation of the class gift. Arisha.
Hello, everyone. My name is Arisha Sobhani, and I have had the honor of serving as the Class of 2023 Treasurer for the past 4 years. It is wonderful to see you all here today, and I'm so proud of all your hard work. I'm confident that you will achieve great success in all your future endeavors. The library at BC has had major renovations in the past year. For our class gift, I'm excited to announce that we will be contributing to these efforts. We will be donating a stained glass artwork of a BC logo. This will be placed in the main window of the library, as this is a west-facing window that will capture the sun's rays and reflect beautifully in the stained glass, attracting the attention of Lancers for many years to come. Congratulations, everyone, and thank you for an incredible 4 years.
Thank you, class of 2023. It's my honor to invite BC Class President Parker Neumeyer to the podium for her commencement address. Parker.
Eight billion people in 193 countries in the world. 50 states in the US and 190 cities with 831 high schools in Wisconsin alone. Yet, for the past 4 years, out of everywhere we could have been, all of our different paths have led us here to the same field house. Before I continue, I want everyone here to take a look around. Look at the people you're sitting by. Introduce yourself if you don't know the person next to you. You guys can look at each other. Now that we got that awkwardness out of the way, I want you guys to look around and find your best friend. See if you know where they're sitting. Take it all in right now, guys, because this is the last time we will ever be in this exact place, surrounded by these exact people. Out of all of the places in the world we could have been, I believe it's no coincidence that we're here together. The people we've passed in the halls for the past 4 years have all played a role in our lives, whether big or small. Along the way, we've formed thousands of connections, with each relationship contributing to the individuals we've become. As I stand here today, I'm incredibly grateful for the past 4 years I've been able to serve as president of one of the most talented classes that has ever walked the halls of Brookfield Central. I'm in constant awe of all the incredible things you've all accomplished. Many of you will be playing a sport at the collegiate level. Some of you have released your own songs and albums on various music platforms. Others are already certified nursing assistants, EMTs, and firefighters. No matter what you guys choose to do, there is no doubt in my mind that every single one of you is capable of success. Now, while it can be daunting to think about having to leave the security of all we've established in high school, from great friends to positions in athletics and other activities, realize this isn't the end. Rather, it's the beginning of the rest of our lives. But before we talk about our futures, let's take a moment to look back and reminisce on simpler times. The days when fidget spinners and slime were our biggest concerns, middle school. Sixth grade, when we somehow got all of our teachers to agree to film mannequin challenges during class. But most unforgettably, seventh grade, when we T-posed our way to getting Wisconsin Hills banned from Worth Park on the last day of school. Now, I'm sure during these times, we wanted nothing more than to escape the awkwardness of middle school and finally be in high school. Like being high schoolers would make all of our problems just disappear. No more awkward crushes where you'd plan to hug at recess, no more braces, no more posting 11-11s on your story or sending dog filter streaks to everyone you know. But I hope now we can realize that as much as we may have hated middle school at the time, those days were kind of fun. We didn't have many responsibilities, and it was during that time we formed connections with our class that have followed us ever since. I truly believe, and I hope you guys can feel it too, that our class has a unique bond not many others get to experience, and it can be traced back to moments like these. Realizing how carefree middle school was, I wish we could have known then how to appreciate the moments we were given without constantly looking forward to the next best thing, which back then was high school. But think about where we are now in life. What next best thing now is causing you to miss out on what's right in front of you? I've realized that in order to maximize your joy, you need to get comfortable living in the moment, even if that moment seems uncomfortable at first. Knowing this will allow you to be more present and appreciative of everything that is right in front of you. When times get hard, take a step back and try to find something to be thankful for. I promise you, even if it's small, there's always something to be thankful for. When you take that step back, you may realize great things exist that you didn't know were there, and life can become so much brighter with just that small change in perspective. Now, I want you all to take one last look around. Pause and take a second to find something in this moment that you're thankful for right now. With that, I cannot wait to see where this life will take all of you. Congratulations, 2023 graduates. We made it.
Thank you, Parker. Service to one's country is the most noble and courageous act that any citizen can perform. We are blessed in our country's history. Countless people have always answered the call in the time of need. To our audience members, please stand if you served our great nation in one of the branches of our military. Please stand now. Thank you for your service. We have six graduates who will be serving our country. I'm proud and honored to recognize the following students for their commitment to the United States. Are they up here yet? Come on up, guys. United States Navy, Liam Imholt, Isma Ruse, and Daniel Gross, United States Navy. United States Marine Corps, Chuck Ridgway. United States Army ROTC, Hunter Simborski, Ariana North. Let's give them a hand. I'd like to welcome the senior orchestra up for their senior song. Thank you, BC Orchestra. It is my pleasure to introduce the class of 2023 valedictorian. During her time at BC, she was a member of Key Club, Student Council, HOSA, Forensics, and National Honor Society. She took 37 honors AP or college courses and finished with 43.5 credits. Her GPA is 5.2, and she'll be attending Union College and Albany Medical College, majoring in leadership in medicine with a direct admit into the BS MBA MD program. It is my pleasure and honor to introduce Muntaha Raza.
Good morning, friends, family members, distinguished guests, and fellow class of 2023 graduates. First and foremost, I want to thank our exceptional teachers and faculty members who've dedicated themselves to our education and inspired us to reach new heights. We are forever grateful for your patience and belief in our potential. To our friends and families, thank you for cheering us on, for attending our events, and for being our unwavering support systems. We would not be standing here today without your love and encouragement. Our time at BC has left an indelible mark on all of our lives. Over the last 4 years, our class has faced and overcome many challenges. When we were thinking of all the things that could go terribly, horribly wrong as nervous freshmen on the first day of high school, I'm sure even none of us had a global pandemic in mind. When faced with an abrupt ending to our freshman year and an unprecedented sophomore year, our class had to adapt to rapid change. We saw the world grapple with social and political discord, but also come together to educate themselves and embrace diversity. In spite of all that was thrown at us, we grew to find success and began to discover our passions. Each of us has worked extremely hard to get here to this day, and I'm proud of all that we have accomplished. But after years of sharing classrooms, celebrating, and commiserating together, our paths are about to diverge as we close this chapter of our lives. Although I'm sure none of us will miss things like having to debate whether to dress for the weather inside the building or outside, it's bittersweet to acknowledge that the comfortable familiarity we've enjoyed walking in the halls of BC has come to an end. If the last 4 years have taught us anything, it's that life has a way of throwing curveballs when we least expect it. Over the past year, we spent a lot of time making decisions about our futures and careers. But we must keep in mind that plans change and dreams take unexpected turns. In a matter of months, we'll be spread out across the country, each chasing our own dreams and goals. As we leave high school, we must embrace the uncertainty that lies ahead and should view it as an invitation to explore the endless possibilities of our lives. It is an opportunity to challenge ourselves, to push beyond our limits, and to redefine what we believe is possible. Of course, with uncertainty comes the risk of failure, which at BC, we have a tendency to overstate. As we enter the real world and are overwhelmed with new choices and opportunities, we will make mistakes and we will choose wrong. But we must provide ourselves with the same compassion that we give to others when we do. We must remember that success is not a one-size-fits-all concept. It is not defined solely by academic achievements, the number of games won, wealth, or social status. Success is as unique as each of us. For some, success may mean making a meaningful impact on the lives of others, whether through acts of kindness, advocacy for a cause, or dedicated service to our communities. For others, success may come in the form of personal growth, overcoming obstacles, and discovering our true passions and purpose. For me, success today meant not writing the speech this morning or falling on my way to the stage. I don't have a magic ball with all or really any of the answers to the future. If I did, I would probably be using it to win the lottery instead of standing here in this cap and gown. But I'm confident that regardless of the path each of us take or where we end up, we will all find our own brand of success. Congratulations, class of 2023. We did it.
The Elmbrook Education Foundation's mission is to promote educational excellence by providing scholarships and grants to the staff and students of Elmbrook. I appreciate the great support that the EEF presents to BC. It's my pleasure to introduce Executive Director of the EEF, Mrs. Beth Dobrzynski. Beth.
Good afternoon. I'm Beth Dobrzynski, the Executive Director of the Elmbrick Education Foundation. In 1958, three $500 scholarships were awarded to Brookfield High School students by a volunteer group of parent and community members. It has since grown into a community-wide scholarship program made possible through the generosity of honorary and memorial funds, community groups, businesses, and school PTOs. Having the EEF administer this program helps to ensure the greatest number of seniors can be honored by our community each year. The EEF takes great care to select recipients that meet the criteria provided by our scholarship sponsors. Over $1.6 million in scholarships has been awarded to our community's graduating seniors through the Elmbrick Education Foundation. This year, the foundation, on behalf of our generous donors, awarded 44 scholarships to students at Brookfield Central and Brookfield East. These students were selected in part because of their commitment to their education, their sincere desire to serve others, and/or their ability to overcome challenges to meet personal goals. Please join me in recognizing and congratulating our scholarship winners and wish them well as they continue on their post-graduation journey. Please stand when I call your name and please hold your applause until the end. Wesley Bartels, Hannah Casey, Saloni Shoraisa, Sydney Christman, Sydney Diver, Jonathan Harmeyer, Nora Hassan, Renee Higgins, AC Hocken, Faith Kim, Jessica Lanza, Georgia Lee, Nathan Labaki, Caitlin McCardle, Aviana Mater, Chelsea Moore, Sanjay Marahi, Princely Patel, Muntaha Raza, Arisha Sabani, William Strader, and Pavan Yeladavili. Thank you very much. Congratulations to this year's. Congratulations to this year's Elmbrick Education Foundation Scholarship recipients, and best of luck to the Brookfield Central High School class of 2023.
talking about the way things change. My family lives in a different state. And if you don't know what to make of this, then we will not delay. And if you don't know what to make of this, then we will not relate.
Thank you, Senior Choir. It's my pleasure and honor to introduce Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Mark Hansen.
Thank you, Mr. Gretzmacher. It is a pleasure to be here today. Congratulations to the class of 2023. You have helped shape Elmbrook into a destination district. I would like to start with a few thank yous. First of all, I'd like to thank the Board of Education for their service to our community. The 2022-2023 school year has been a unique year for Elmbrook, and our Board of Education has been a guiding force for our entire community. Thank you. I also want to thank the administrative team at Brookfield Central for their commitment to excellence. Additionally, to the staff from BC for their pledge to this great work, the work of being an educator. Thank you for your dedication, devotion to our students, their families, and the entire community. As well, to parents and families gathering today to celebrate the class of 2023, thank you. Thank you for trusting us with your children. Thank you for being a guide on the side as their journey continues. Finally, to the class of 2023, well done. Thank you for your perseverance as you completed some of the most rigorous academic requirements and academic expectations in the entire state of Wisconsin. And you did it during the most unusual of times. You did it with grace, dignity, patience, and tremendous agility. Today is further evidence that Elmbrook's recipe for academic success is working. Committed parents, guiding engaged students who work with incredibly talented staff. What a recipe. This is an amazing community to live, work, and play. The education of our children remains a top priority, and we are fortunate to have such a partnership. We are also fortunate to have incredibly talented staff that pour their heart and soul into this thing called school. In particular, you have an amazing leader in this school who has created memories for you. Thank you to Mr. Gretzmacher for all that you do. As he always says, never miss a chance to say thank you. Thank you for your tireless efforts to make BC an amazing place for staff and students. He is a giant in the field of education. As high schools go, so goes an entire community, and this high school is crushing it right now. Here's the story. I graduated from high school a long time ago, really long time ago. Being totally honest with all of you, I do not remember anything from any speaker from that day. I realize I run the risk of being Mr. Irrelevant, but I hope to offer a few thoughts, maybe some advice, and hopefully a small memory or two. I promise it will be brief and I won't drone on. It won't be 60 minutes like some speakers do. I probably could lengthen it to 30 minutes, but was recently reminded that no one here is going to remember anything I say. At least we have a microphone. I was also told the best thing I could do is just sit down. Those of you that know me know that I have a hard time with that. So I hope to offer a few perspectives. The first item I want to share is a celebration of what this class has accomplished. The second item I want to share is a top 10-ish list. That brings me to my first point. Class of 2023, you guys crushed it. This class has achieved heights unsurpassed in the district from an academic, athletic, activities, and arts perspective. Listen to these accomplishments from the class of 2023. Average grade point average exceeds 3.5. Graduation rate, 99%. Of you are going to a 2 or 4 year school. You earned 431 dual enrollment or transcripted credits. That does not include advanced placement. Prior to their senior year, this class of 2023 took 504 advanced placement exams with a score of 3 or higher. Assuming 3 college credits for each exam at a tuition cost of $1,200, that is over $600,000 in tuition avoidance. Add senior year AP classes, and this number climbs north of $1 million. Your parents appreciate that. Understanding that a graduation requirement is 24 credits, the average number of credits per graduate in the class of 2023, 27.3. 136 of you will graduate with 28 or more credits. 38 of you will graduate with 30 or more credits. And one of you have north of 42 credits. Congratulations to the class of 2023. In addition to that, this class has earned over $2 million in scholarships. 242 students took 1,546 courses for college credit while in high school. That's nearly 80% of this class for advanced placement college credit. And 6 of you will take on the greatest devotion to duty by joining the military. Thanks for being you. It is clear that you have prepared well for the next part of the journey. 13 years of school helped ready you for your next steps. My best to you as you embark on the journey of life. Bear with me for just a bit more. This is the part where a normal graduation speech would talk about how you are on the precipice of your next chapter in life. They would talk about the milestones, the friendships, the tears, shared laughter, and all the resiliency and grit that you endured. I'm going to pivot from that, though. As some of you know, I'm a list kind of person. I have to-do lists, shopping lists, gift idea lists, urgent lists, bucket lists, reading lists, lists of passwords, and lists of gratitude. And I have a list for you. It is a list that I started years ago, has stood the test of time, and may very well be the only thing you remember from this epic superintendent speech. As I wrap up, listen closely, as this is the part you want to remember. It will be in the form of a top 10-ish list. Number 10, be excellent. If you have to do something, do it right the first time, do it right every time. Nothing halfway, ever. Promise? Number 9, fingerprints. Remember that you are leaving fingerprints in life. Some are digital, some are personal. Be sure your fingerprints are ones that you are proud of as a person, as a friend, as a son or daughter, and as a citizen of this community and this country. Number 8, pay it forward. Always remember that there were a number of people that gave of their time to help you with your growth and development. You got to stand on the shoulders of some amazing people on your journey. Pay it forward as you move through life by giving back to others. Be a hero to somebody. Number 7, leave it better than you found it. Regardless of the situations you enter, make them a better place for those that are there now and those that will be there in the future. Number six, always show up, even if no one is watching. Number five, don't text and drive, don't speed, avoid the use of profanity, and try not to break the law. These are all bad things that usually have bad endings. And so as to honor my promise of brevity, I'm cutting out 4, 3, and 2 and finishing with the most important. You still with me? Number one, always call home. Don't text them and think that it filled them with joy to hear from you via a digital message. Call them and call them often. Stay connected with them and you'll find out just how smart they are. They are or will become your best friends. Members of the class of 2023, I trust you will make the most of these opportunities that you have been given. Thank you for making the School District of Elmbrook and the communities we serve great places. You have made for a wonderful year at your school and a wonderful experience in the School District of Elmbrook. We are a great place to think, to learn, and to succeed because of your work. Thank you again, and best wishes.
Thank you, Mark, for your leadership this year and every year. It's my pleasure and honor to invite Senior Class Vice President Alyssa Tang to the podium. Alyssa.
Our high school experience was unconventional, to say the least. We started freshman year off strong by attending football games and homecoming, participating in sports and clubs, and connecting with new teachers and classmates. We became more accustomed to the routines and felt we belonged in a new place, a long way to go from the go-home freshman chance in the fall. Then we were ready for that final stretch of just a few more months to conclude our first year of high school. Until that fateful day, March 13th, 2020. Over the intercom, Mr. Gritzmacher announced we would receive an extended spring break, to which we all felt immense relief because we desperately needed a break at that point in the year. However, we didn't expect that extra week of spring break to turn into virtual learning from home for the rest of the school year during lockdown. Suddenly, our normal hit pause. From there, our sophomore year became a blur. While some of us had to navigate through full days of virtual learning, others had to readjust to a new version of high school that involved social distancing measures and mask-wearing procedures. We also missed out on more of the high school experience. Another homecoming and spring fling, seasons of watching athletic events, a year of fundraising for junior prom, and even paper AP exams. We had a unique mix of feelings and experiences through this unusual period of disconnection. We yearned to connect with others, but also relished in the comfort of our homes. We may have overcome struggles with mental health or family finances. We may have found it more challenging to maintain healthy habits or productive studying skills. Yet, even through those times, we reunited our junior year stronger than before. We underwent quite a turnaround. We undertook more rigorous course loads, leadership positions, and jobs. We witnessed a competitive class council election with high stakes to organize Powder Puff, Mr. BC, and prom. It was both a time to seriously consider and start planning for our futures and still have fun. Upon reflecting on our journey to graduating, I discovered that a pandemic couldn't hold us back from seeking opportunities to better ourselves and the community. Throughout senior honors night, I thought to myself in astonishment at all the good my classmates have done. Volunteering, starting businesses, pursuing service projects, stepping up to leadership roles, and so much more. They ceased to impress me with all their triumphs and accomplishments. I'm beyond proud to be a part of such a talented, caring, and dedicated class. Our ability to strive for our goals and initiate change in the face of adversity serves as a testament to our strength that will rise above any given situation. Alas, our senior year has come to an end. We've completed all the required courses and traditions, we've said goodbye to teachers, and we've left behind a legacy with our perseverance, character, and determination. With the limitless opportunities ahead of us, I'm confident we'll continue to pave our paths through anything that comes our way. Thank you.
Thank you.
Students who will be receiving an honors diploma today are wearing a gold cord and tassel, and will have a logo in gold on the screen when he or she receives their diploma. Students must have a cumulative GPA of 3.5 and must have taken 6 or more honors, transcripted, or AP credits in order to qualify for the honors diploma. 40% of our graduates today have earned this honor. I'm proud to introduce our diploma ceremony readers for today, Mr. Ron Blaha and Ms. Allison Hickman.
Samuel Auclair. Supriya Ajampour. Estella Albrecht. Sin Akala. Maya Alexander. Tulin Alkatanani. Raul Amor. Nicholas Anderson. Riley Angst. Carolyn Armstrong. Jordan Babalola. Jihong Bay. Mauhid Bajwa. Wesley Bartels. Vincenzo Bean. Anthony Bemke. Molly Benjamins. Jacob Bergman. Miley Bernotas. Mahi Basur. Jack Bechner. Johanna Bechner. Fernando Bykovsky. Ananya Bhatt. Jordan Beek. Kennedy Bishop. Jacob Bivens. Annie Blake. Rebecca Bodie. Kaysan Boyven. Sarah Bampan Benabita. Mario Bonilla. Keller Borsch. Matthew Boschek. Jack Brand. Noah Bruce. Jacob Brunner. Quinlan Bodie. Juliet Boutel. Hannah Burns. Stephen Birch. Danielle Canitz. Jack Carter. Hannah Casey. James Casper. Hannah Castrillo. Ava Cavallari. Trinity Saberowitz. Natalia Shabe. Diksha Chand. Saloni Charesia. Ezine Chioma. Michael Choi. Sydney Christman. Daniel Kaufman. Sophia Cram. Sophia D'Amato. Isabella Danowski. Ashita Darshan Lakonade. Malachi Davey. Henry Arthur DeLeon Nieves. Addison Decker. Jacob Decker. Michael Denke. Andrea Della Penna. Zachary Dallas. Aditya Damampure. Emily Demarath. Molly Durango. Simran Dhaliwal. Jonathan Diego. Zachary Dinesen Weiger. Charles DiPiazza. Sydney Diver. John Donahue. Apollonia Dragota. Noah Dreyer.
Sarah Duff. Quinn Dahl. Drew Edmond. Aaron Effort. Alexandra Imachi. Natalia Emanuel. Elliot Eng. Audrey Fong. Michael Franz. Tillman Fryer. Sarah Galliano. Evan Galarza. Raymond Gaunt. Jack Gaboy. Joseph Geibel. William Goddard. Anna Gosenheimer. Elise Gosset. Paris Green. Elena Gregory. Noah Griepentrog. Daniel Gross. Matthew Gritzmacher. Thomas Heffernan. Obada Hamad. Razan Hamada. Andrew Harrelson. Jonathan Harmeyer. Haley Hartnett. Noura Hassan. Maria Hassanain. Gabriel Hawks. Madeline Headkey. Reva Hegde. James Heckers. Alia Oz. Renee Higgins. Daniel Ho. AC Hawken. Ryan Herring. Joshua Hootkin. Lily Horvath. Grace Ho. Aaron Hu. Shane Hunter. Liam Imholt. Jonathan Jacobs. Matthew Jacobson. Gracie Jaitner. Braden James. Claire Jensen. Amelia Jorgensen. Kieran Joshi. Noreen Kamal. Aditya Kante. Rhea Kapoor. Anastasios Karampetsos. Kavyashri Karumuri. Harnur Kaur. Gregory Kay. Avanti Kakane. Shelja Kayla. Maxwell Kellogg. Aminra Kimmet. Alexandra Keel. Faith Kim. Brendan King. Christian Kinney. Oliver Kish. Addison Clam. Maria Klug. Lily Kellner. Darren Creel. Divya Krishnan. Rohan Kirpad.
Zachary Kusheski. Naomi Kuchera. Jessica Lanza. Brendan Larson. Sean Larson. Emily Lavin. Georgia Lee. Lincoln Lee. Owen Lessiter. Joshua Levy. Aaron Liu. Richard Lobo. Nathan Labaki. Jerry Liu. Caleb Ludwig. Anthony Mack. Nitya Madadi. Carter Madasian. Ethan Madasian. Luke Mamalakis. Megan Manganero. Pudge Manohar. Samantha Maples. Anirudh Maya. Caitlin McCardle. Rory McDermid. Nelia McDonnell. Micah McGowan. Alexander Medeiros. Aviana Mader. Joshua Melcher. Umika Minaria. Ryan Marino Reyes. Julian Myers. William Miller. Chelsea Moore. Yusuke Morita. Audrey Moa. Brandon Moyer. Sanjay Raj Murali. Maya Now. Emma Nell. Parker Neumeier. Chiara Nocentini. Ariana North. Alana O'Neill. Meja Oaks. Benjamin Otto. Maya Pagel. Swarit Pakala. Pranav Paladugu. Princy Patel. Sahaj Paudel. Daniel Peterson. Zoe Peterson. Mason Farr. Dominic Piccini. Gray Plaley. Carly Plate. Lillian Player. Madison Pottinger. Bryce Potter. Claire Pertell. Shonuk Riker. Mahit Rajesh. Om Rajpal. Elizabeth Ramon. Liam Rao. Muntaha Raza. Richard Reiter. Connor Renner. Chuck Ridgway. Plankat Rinkum.
Gabriella Rise. Rebecca Ritchie. Liz Ruiz. Nathan Roscoff. Gavin Roop. Elizabeth Rush. Maria Jose Rubalcaba. Shefali Sanwal. Bhavya Saxena. Lexi Schauer. Timothy Schmidt. Benjamin Schnabel. Caitlin Schultze. Rihanna Sadie. Stuart Seymour. Lola Schaefer. Olivia Schaefer. Mardav Shah. Varun Shankar. Tabriz Sharwani. Catherine Sheldon. Mahika Shetty. Helena Simon Resende. Andrew Sinclair. Jasdeep Singh. Arisha Sobani. Tanishka Soni. Sinjana Srinivas. Joseph Staff. Gabrielle Stosky. Zachary Stepp. Nathan Stewart. Garrett Stokelbush. William Strader. Calvin Streit. Aditya Sundaresan. Kate Sutton. Cohen Swanson. McKinley Sweeney. Hunter Simborski. Alyssa Tang. Mia Tang. Anna Tursky. Sanjanathan Tirunavukarasu. Joel Thomas. Ethan Tishoni. Connor Tice. Sean Tinnen. Akshita Tirumalaraju. Khalil Towns. Andrea Trzesneski. Abby Turner. Soam Udani. Ram Vaidyanathan. Isaac Van Bodegum Smith. Kenny Vang. Christopher Weyerstaller. Maisha Wadawan. Robert Weiner. Callie Weishar. Faye Weissman. Gabriel Weitzer. Tyler Wells. Ellie Weeder. Luke Wilinski. Parker Williams. Madeline Winter. Annalise Yang. Jordan Yang. Catherine Yi. Pavan Yalayavili. Joe Yu. Isak Yunus. Daniel Zhu. Ziggy Ziegler.
Members of the class of 2023, at this time, I ask that you stand, please. It is through the powers granted to me from the superintendent and the Board of Education from the School District of Elmbrook that I declare that you have successfully met the graduation requirements outlined by the State of Wisconsin and the School District of Elmbrook. I ask that you move your tassel to the left to signify your graduation status. Parents, family, friends, I present to you the BC class of 2023. Thank you for sharing this special day with us. Parents, guests, everyone have a fantastic summer. Be safe.